it's the part 3 of chemistry, language of chemistry topic, and in this video we are going to study the topic how to balance a chemical reaction. So let's start with it. Whenever chemical reaction takes place, there is no loss or gain of atoms, there is no gain or loss of any atom, only arranged rearrangement of atoms take place, through that the number of atoms are the same. Hence the chemical equation has to be balanced, and the and same number of atoms have to be maintained on the both sides of reaction, so that to satisfy the law of conservation of mass. Now we are going to do the chemical reactions. Earlier we have did the chemical equations. So now what is chemical reaction? The chemical reaction is said to take place when old matter transforms to into a new substance or substances. When the chemical reaction is said to take place if the old matter transforms to the new substance. Chemical reactions are broadly classified into the four main types: synthesis reaction, decomposition reaction, simple displacement, and double displacement. These are the four types of chemical reaction. Firstly, we are going to do synthesis reactions, combinations, or reaction. Synthesis reactions, combination reactions, both types. So when two or more substances combine to chemically form a single product, to form a single one product, the reaction is known to as synthesis reaction. Let's understand by example. Like these are both are reactants, and when they combine it form a single product AB. A plus B reactants equals to single AB product. Like 2H2O H2 plus O2 is equals to, in on electric and spark, that is form is 2H2O. Why it is a synthesis reactions, combination reactions. So next examples again, CO plus O2 is equals to CO2 on heating. 3 magnesium 3Mg plus N2 heat Mg3N2. Same Zn zinc plus S sulfur equals to heat on equals to heat on Znas zinc sulfur. Zinc sulfide. P4 phosphorus plus 5 oxygen 2 equals to 2 phosphorus, 2 means 2 arrangement, and phosphorus 2O5. N nitrogen plus hydrogen on Fe means to minusing on the degree, it is 2NH3. Next is 2SO, means to say if it is both two combination like this, 2SO2 plus oxygen on this vault, 2SO3. 2Hg plus O2 equals 2HgO. Mercury oxygen equals to metal oxide, but mercury oxygen on this degree is equals to 2SO3. What do you observe? When coal is burnt like this, coal is burnt on splinter, it is formed like this. When coal is burnt, it catches the fire immediately, and reactions take place. When they are burnt, it burns in air to form colorless. It burns to form colorless. Colorless gas and turns the lime water milky. The lime water milky. Unburnt carbon is left behind as ash. Like this, it is left behind as ash. So coal, C for coal plus oxygen equals to CO2 carbon dioxide. Coal is black and oxygen from the air equals to colorless carbon dioxide. Next is when hydrogen and oxygen are ignified. Ice report for condensing water vapors. Red color means hydrogen cylinder. Drops of water from here, when heated, the drops of water are coming in the bowl by the hydrogen cylinder when it makes the ice rattled heat. When hydrogen burns in air, it burns with a blue flame.
when hydrogen burns like this, hydrogen burns, it burns with a blue flame and pop sound to form water vapor. And there is a pop sound, like pop sound from dipping water to form water vapor when it is heated, and water vapors are from the condensing ice retort. These vapors condense and fall as droplets of water like this. Equation is like that, 2H2 plus O2 equals to 2H2O. 2H2O, why? Because it is hydrogen and it is oxygen. When it is heat, the water droplets come down and some water droplets go and condense as water vapors. Other reactions, mainly these: decomposition reaction, simple displacement, and double decomposition. We will do in next part 4. Thanks for watching the part 3, and part 4 is coming soon. Please follow the all parts.